different kind of you know aptitude why because certain people could remember pictographic images very well certain people could Hello everyone. In the previous videos, I have discussed about the previous year questions that have been there in the chapter of learning from psychology. Now, today I'll be discussing about the questions which have been there in chapter memory. Now, in 2024, they have asked two questions from memory. So, we'll be discussing about those questions that have been there in 2024. So, let's begin. Now, one of the questions of memory 2024 was that differentiate between the processes of memory and forgetting. Also discuss multi-store model and meta memory as innovation in the study of memory. Now, firstly, they have focused on that you need to differentiate between what? Between the processes of memory and forgetting. That means first you need to know that you have to talk about how the information gets stored in the memory, right? So basically they are talking about what? Encoding. Fine. Now, then they are talking about what? Forgetting. So, they are asking you how do people or how are people able to forget. Now, for the information that gets stored in the memory, how are the things happening? So, just see how does actually the information storage happening in the memory. So, first thing is that the input that is coming from sensory memory, fine. Now, this input is going to short-term memory. And from here, it is moving to long-term memory. Now see, how is this ultimately happening? The sensory memory is actually encoding your information. Fine. Now, this information is retained in short-term memory. Now, why short-term memory? Because now you will decide that for how long you want the information to be there. For example, if you are able to recall a phone number for that matter, that means that is going to be there in your short-term memory because you want to remember that information with respect to phone number just for dialing purpose, right? Now, when it comes to long-term memory, what is happening is that you want a certain information to be there in your for a long term, or that means or for that matter I can say that you want that information to be held in your memory for rest of your life and all. So that way you decide how how you are going to have that information in your memory. So the process of information storage is this. Now when I come to forgetting part, how is forgetting part happening? Now see, in the forgetting part, either there is any kind of encoding failure. Encoding failure means that you didn't got the information rightly in your memory, maybe in your short-term memory, the information processing happening through sensory part was disrupted. So that way, if there is encoding failure. Now second could be in case the information that you are getting, there's a lot of interference. So that way it is going to be difficult to retain that information. Now, other than that, what is going to happen is, if retaining becomes difficult, then there are high chances that you are not able to recall also. So retrieval also becomes difficult. So if retrieval is not possible, for that matter, it could be the information that has been long there, so there are high chances that you didn't wanted it to be present, and for that matter you didn't recalled it, so there could be a decay of information for that matter. So decay. So now all this is eventually leading to what? Forgetting. Fine. So one I have discussed, that is your information processing part. So this was your how the information is processed. Then I discussed with you how the information is forgotten. Fine. So this was the first part of the question that we discussed. Now they say that also discuss the multi-store model and meta memory as innovation in the study of memory. So multi-store model, you also know that, you know, firstly encoding of the information is happening, then processing of the information is happening, then decoding of the information is happening. So that model you have to discuss. There is nothing that I need to tell you in this part. Why? Because it is very basic and it's clear to everyone. Now what I need to go for is that and meta memory. Now what is meta memory? Now see, there are people with a different kind of aptitude. Why? Because certain people could remember pictographic images very well, certain people could retain information if they are in the form of mnemonics, etc. So in that way, if you are having good knowledge about your own memory, that means how you are going to store that information, that is called this meta memory model. So in meta memory, what you need to discuss is that you need to have a good information with respect to working of your memory. Fine. So this way you are going to attempt this question. Similarly, you can write examples. For example, I told you that when you want to remember a phone number, for that matter, so that is there in your short-term memory. But if you want to remember that who are your grandparents, who are your parents, so that is there in your long-term memory. So what happens is that there are certain information that we ourselves want to forget, there are certain information we want to remember. So remember, both is the aspect of memory. Forgetting, you can also write about one more aspect, that is willingly you want to forget certain things. So why you want to forget willingly? Because certain incidences are very traumatic. So for that matter, you don't want the information to be held, right? So those information are very traumatic, so you want that information to just go away with time. So that way forgetting is that part also there. Fine. Okay, now let's move on to the next question. The next question says that citing research evidence, explain the components of working memory. Now here you have to talk about researchers and explain the components of memory. Now working memory, what are those? Now in working memory, the various parts that you are going to talk about, that means there are informations which are getting continuously processed and they are also getting continuously updated. So working memory, the most important aspect is that the information is getting updated. Fine. So now let's see what are the components of working memory and what are those research evidences that explain the components of working memory. So in the next part that you are going to talk about is, first is your central executive system. Now, what is happening is that central executive system of a working memory is going to decide the information that is, you know, in the initial level, which information you are actually talking about. So the central executive system, the information that is stored and which needs to be updated, the very first part starts from here. Now, the next thing what happens is you have to talk about phonological aspects. You have to talk about visual spatial aspect. Now, central executive, I have talked about what that which information need to be, you know, updated. So central executive part begins from there. Now, phonological aspect, what is phonological? So first we'll write about the information that you need or you want to be updated. Now, what are the phonological loop? For example, the information that is continuously in your, or the auditory information. So what is happening is, continuously recalling. Now, this happens, for example, if you're continuously recalling, continuously reminding yourself, what happens is that the information gets a hold. So that way, phonological part. Now, the next one is the visual spatial part. Now, what is the visual spatial part? Now, this part is talking about what? Visuals and spatial informations. That means whatever you are visualizing or whatever you know, visions you are having, so that is going to take part in your information processing. Fine. Other than that, what happens is ki if these three parts is covered, there is one more segment that is there, that is your episodic memory or episodic buffer. Now, what is episodic buffer? See, any information that is getting processed remains redundant if we don't connect the dots. That means, you know, how are you going to remember the information that got processed? It is only possible if that information is there, connected, and, you know, it could be recalled through certain events, through certain you know, things that is happening in front of you, or you can actually, you know, remember through an episode. So that's how the working memory is going to take place. That means how, that's how the information that is going to take place in your working memory. That means this part retains the information in the forms of events. Fine. So central executive is there. Phonological part is there, which talks about auditory information. Okay. Then is visual spatial part that talks about the visual information. And then is your episodic buffer, which is talking about the events part. Now, this is the major segment of the working memory. What you can do is that, you know, doing a little bit of research. There's a lot of research that is run by Bradley Thompson, for that matter. You can talk about all the research that are done by Bradley Thompson. You can also talk about the research by Logie, etc. Now, what is happening is that you can provide the examples of, you know, various research that have been done by them in different aspects. So this is how you are going to attempt this question of working memory. Fine. Thank you so much.